Another nice feature that has been added to Excel 2007 is improved sorting and filtering. Now you can quickly arrange your worksheet data by applying enhanced filtering and sorting capabilities. You can sort data by a minimum of 3 levels and a maximum of 64 levels. You can sort by color and display more than 1,000 items in the Auto Filter drop-down list. Sorting and filtering allow you to manage your Excel data better, and we will cover more about this later in the tutorial. Another new feature that's available in Excel 2007 is improved charting and charting tools. Notice that now when you create a chart in Excel, you have a new ribbon feature called Chart Tools with 3 tabs: Design, Layout, and Format. Through these 3 tabs of the ribbon, you can apply the new charting tools and features. Shared charting is also now available. Shared charting means that a chart is shared between Excel, Word, and PowerPoint. In prior releases of Microsoft Office, charts were created by Microsoft Graph for both Word and PowerPoint, whereas Excel used a worksheet to contain the charting data sheet. Now Microsoft Office charts are generated using Excel's chart data sheet for both Word and PowerPoint. This brings the rich functionality of Excel charting, which includes the use of formulas, filtering, sorting, and the ability to link a chart to an external data source like Microsoft's SQL Server. This linking provides a real-time delivery of information displayed in a chart in any Microsoft Office product. An Excel worksheet is actually used to hold the data of your chart, but is stored in the Word or PowerPoint document or within a separate Excel document. By storing the charted data in a separate Excel data sheet, it will reduce the file size for the Word or PowerPoint document. There are other enhancements and functionality that have been added to Excel 2007. Pivot tables are now easier to create and use than in previous releases of Excel. There is a new pivot table user interface that allows you to select the fields that you want to see from a new pivot table field list. Pivot tables are not covered in this course, but you can learn more about pivot tables through the Excel help file and Microsoft's website. Microsoft Office 2007 now offers new file formats. You now have an XML-based format that Microsoft calls the Office Open XML format. This new format offers better integration with external data sources and provides smaller file sizes and improved data recovery. An Excel 2007 document now uses an XML-based file extension of .xlsx. There are 3 other XML-based formats that are specific to macro-enabled files. Now Excel offers the macro-enabled format, which ends in an extension of .xlsm, as well as Excel templates format, which ends in an extension of .xltx, and macro-enabled Excel templates format, which ends in an extension of .xltm. In addition to these XML-based file formats, Microsoft also has added a binary version of the segmented compressed file format for a large or complex workbook. This file format is called the Office Excel 2007 Binary File Format, or BIFF12. Using the BIFF12 format allows for optimal performance and backward compatibility with earlier versions of Excel. We will learn more about the various formats used in Excel for saving files later in this tutorial. Another new feature of Excel 2007 is its ability to share worksheet and workbooks with others. Through Excel services, you can share your Excel 2007 worksheet data with others throughout an organization. When you publish a workbook to Excel services, others can then view it through Office Excel web access and a browser. They can view, print, analyze, and even extract worksheet data even if they do not have Excel installed on their computer. We will learn more about sharing information from Excel with others later in this tutorial. All these features and enhancements make Excel 2007 very robust, versatile, and powerful. Let's move on to the next movie so that we can learn more about Excel 2007.